a bird just flew to my window and almost knocked on my window. My mom. So of course there's gonna be craziness happening when I start filming, of course. Everything was good up until I started recording and then like it just went wild. I don't know. Good morning, guys. I hope y'all are having a wonderful day so far. It's been a minute. I haven't been as consistent as I wanted to this year, and that's for a few reasons, but I'm gonna try again. See, I always say I'm gonna try again, but sometimes it works out, sometimes it doesn't. It's just that life gets in the way, and for me right now, this is a hobby. I usually use YouTube to sort out my mental health, to relax, and just feel happy because this makes me really, really happy. I wanted to do a get ready with me and just life update and just talk to y'all about anything. First life update, I got glasses. I've been needing glasses for a bit. I wore this for the intro just so y'all could see them because I'm gonna do my makeup, so I'm gonna take them off for the rest of the video. I'm balancing everything on my couches, so I have no idea how well this is gonna turn out. So for videos like this, I don't always have a plan in mind. I just kind of go with it and say whatever is on my mind. This past month, or actually these past like couple of months, I have actually been working on myself quite a bit and just growing and getting through some things. I feel like every single time that that happens, I talk to one of my friends about it, and I always want to share it online, some of the things we discuss, because they can get pretty interesting and I feel like it can help somebody else. And the main reason for this channel, the main reason for my Instagram, is just to help people out. And I usually share things on my Instagram more than here. Here I try to keep it more fun, but I kind of want to change my niche a little, just a little, to be more that positivity. That's what I created my channel for. I created it for mothers, but it's taken kind of a turn and now it's basically for everybody. I gear more towards women just because that's what I know, but I've seen my demographics and they're split in half, which is always interesting to me, but I find that really cool. So over this past month, I have really dove into just working on myself and working on who I want to be. A lot has happened this past year and I just wanted to appreciate what I have more than looking for the future, looking for the next thing. And I have started being more positive and optimistic, and this past year I have changed so much. Even this past month, I feel like there's just been such a change in just my overall vibe, because I've gotten good news and just been trying harder to be positive, to be an optimistic, to be an optimist, because things are constantly happening that I just want to be grateful for what I have right now and who I have right now. There's days that I struggle a lot mentally, and I take it out mostly on food, and it sucks, but I've been working on that, and that's why this past month I've been focusing a lot on body positivity and being my authentic self on Instagram and now on here as well. I already am authentic on here. It's just I want to show y'all more of me and who I am. I'm occasionally gonna pause and just like do my makeup and then keep talking. I've really been focusing on just like being grateful for what I have and being an optimist and thinking about why I love myself, why I love my family, why I love just people in general, because I feel like life is just hard and it also passes by really quickly. As Zoe gets older, I realize how fast life is passing. And I don't want to waste that time being negative. I don't want to waste my 20s being negative and then being resentful later on because I decided to be negative. I would rather spend my 20s being an optimist, being positive, loving my daughter, loving my husband, loving my family, my friends, everybody. And I realized during this past month that I've been doing that more. I've also prayed a lot for friendships and relationships, and I've been blessed more with the friendships that I have now. I've made a couple of good friends lately that have stuck by me and know who I am and know me completely, and I love that. And all these friends, what's crazy is that almost all these friends, I knew them at one point or another. One of them, Cruz, knew in like middle school, and I've reconnected with all of them. It's so crazy because now we knew each other maybe in, you know, elementary, middle, high school, and right there we were all basically on the same path. But now as an adult, we're all on different paths and we're all just trying to be happy, trying to be successful, trying to be positive. So why not just bounce that off each other, bounce that energy off each other? And that's what we've been doing. And I love that these are people that like have known me since, you know, years ago, and they can see the change already through me. Certain friends that I have currently that I feel like I'm supposed to be friends with them, like I feel it, that our energies just like click. And I know I probably sound kind of crazy. It's been a weird month, guys. Definitely been more diving into my flower childness lately, and definitely have been just grateful and loving. So I've been praying, and I was praying a lot for friendships, relationships, and growth a lot. And what's funny is that when I meant growth, I meant growth to start my career off, whether it's this or something else. I wanna just have a positive influence, and this is what I feel like it is right now. What's funny, it came in a different way. During this time, I became way more optimistic. I became way more positive, diving into who I wanna be and working towards that. And I think that's something we all need to do. If you're not satisfied with who you are, just work on it. A big thing that helped me do that was because I was, I tend to struggle a lot with food, and I don't talk about it on here, but I struggle a lot with food. I struggle a lot with my appearance and who, and just everything health-wise. I struggle a lot with it, and that's my own doing. My husband started helping me not just figure out how to solve it, but get to the root of problems and work from there. And because he helped me do that, I realized why I do certain things. I realized why I, you know, binge, or why I decide not to eat at certain times or something like that. And it's hard. It's heartbreaking sometimes to figure it all out, honestly. It's hard. But I definitely think it's better because I don't want to focus on how I look. That's not why I went on a health journey. That's not why I started working. Well, initially, that is why I started working out, because I knew I was getting unhealthy and I knew I didn't look like I wanted to. But the ultimate reason I work out is because I struggle a lot mentally, and this is what helps me. Okay, so I brined it a little and I'm trying to get it to focus on me. I don't know why it's not focusing, but I'm just gonna keep rolling with it. That's kind of what I've been doing, and I can definitely talk more about it if y'all would kind of like that. I've been trying to share it more and more on my Instagram so far, to spread just positivity and kind of what it's like, because sometimes I feel like, because I'm a mom, and I know a lot of moms feel this, you just have to feel like you have to be the perfect mom all the time. We set this expectations that we have to be perfect all the time, and really it's not. Most of the time it's hard. Most days But it's also beautiful. I'm definitely grateful that I get to be a mom. And this past month, I've also been trying to just fight all my toxic traits that I've noticed that I've had, whether they're things I learned from my family, school, or a TV show, or something I just picked up on. I've been trying to fight all of that and not pass that down. I don't want her to struggle with her food or her body or anything like that. This talk just got like way too real. I usually don't get this real on my channel, but I've gotten a little bit more real on my Instagram, and I want to also do that here, where I won't just talk about like working out or stuff like that. Like, I want to talk about why I do it behind it. I want to talk about the body positivity and how no matter how much weight you lose, no matter what you do, you're still in the same body. This is the same body I had 1 or 2 years ago when I was at my heaviest weight. This is the same body. I've just changed it, and who I am is still here. It's just changed. It's morphed. It's upgraded. I can't trade in my body. My body stays my body. Not just be okay, I have this body. Like, love it and be happy in it, you know? So, because I'm not gonna get another body. That's really what I've been focusing on, and that's why I think over the past month or so, I have had just kind of a complete like mental shift. I've also been just very spiritual lately, and that's a completely different story. But I don't know if we're ready to talk about all of that just yet. I'm deciding whether I want to leave it like this or put a little bit of shimmer. I'm gonna put something in the inner corner. I cannot do a wing liner to save my life. So I recently saw that video of I think it was Lucy Hale. She did a, and I've seen a lot of people do this, like a brown wing, but it was with eyeshadow, and I was like, let me try that out. And I tried it out yesterday for the first time, and I really liked it. And so when I do this, I don't actually use black. I use like a really dark brown, and I feel like it looks so much better. Okay, but on this side, for some reason, it's always harder for me to do. Never comes out. But what's awesome about doing this is that since it's shadow, it's much easier to clean up than like liquid or gel. And see, up close, it's not that great. It's not. But from a distance, like, it kind of looks like I can do a wing liner in a way. Using setting spray. That did not get in my face at all. So I'm so weird. I'll use like Max Fix Plus after I use all the powders to make sure that they melt into my skin, and then I'll use like my lipstick, my mascara, and everything. Usually my mascara I do at very, very last, but then I'll put like a different setting spray to make me look glowy. I'm already pretty glowy from the setting spray, but let's add a little bit of highlighter, just a tiny bit. It's my favorite highlighter. And that is the look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys enjoy these kinds of videos so I can do them more often for y'all. I really want to talk more about body positivity, body appreciation, body love. I can only talk about my personal experience and how things have helped me, because I have been in a dark place before, and I have gotten out of that dark place many, many times. But I can definitely be open, and I want to be transparent with y'all as much as I can be, because I still keep a quite a bit of my personal life private, because I kind of don't want to put everything out on the internet. But I try to be as transparent about those parts of my life as much as I can be. That was a long chatty, but I'm pretty much a chatterbox. Go ahead and comment down below if you want me to do more of these videos, or give this video a thumbs up so I know, and let me know in the comments what you would like me to talk more about. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, go ahead and subscribe and hit the notification bell so you get notified whenever I make a new video. Hopefully it becomes a schedule. Go ahead and follow me on my Instagram and my TikTok if you're not already following me. Thank you for sticking with me through this video. I am glad to be back, and hopefully I make more videos like this. Love you guys. Bye.